Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, welcome back to my English channel. How are you doing? Hopefully everything is going to be well. In the previous lesson, you have learned about review text, and I gave you an assignment to create a movie review. Here is the movie review of Princess Mononoke by Nuru Asga, and here is the video.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, my name is Nuru Asga Skedin from Top Science 3, and I'm going to review a Studio Ghibli film called Princess Mononoke. So, I'm going to explain the plot first, and I'm going to give my thought about this film. So let's get into it. Yeah, the first one is the plot. And once upon a time, there was a village, and this village was about to get attacked by a demon, but its prince, called Ashikaka, he was able to kill the demon right before it reaches the village. So the village were totally fine, but unfortunately, its corruption cursed Ashikaka's right arm. So he's got cursed, and the wise woman of the village told him that he may find cure on West Island. And Ashikaka was like, okay, I'm going to West. I am going to West. Okay. After that, on his way to West, he met this guy, Jikobu. So Jikobu is one of the antagonists of this film. And Jikobu told him that he may seek help from the forest spirit for his cursed right arm, and Ashikaka was like, okay, thank you for your advice, and I'm going to give it a shot. After that, he was on his way to forest, and he was passing by a river, and on the river, he met San. San, this amazing girl, is daughter of wolf goddess called Moro, and she was a human. She is a human, but she raised by wolf's pack, so she lived in the forest with wolf's pack. And Ashikaka was like, she's so beautiful, she's so brave and stuff. And I think Ashikaka was fell in love on the first sight. I don't know, but no one knows. But their first meeting was kind of remarkable, and they were like just looking at each other from side to side of the river. And yeah, San went out with her wolves, and Ashikaka was looking her back. Okay, after that, at the same time in the river, Ashikaka found a two guys who was injured, and these two guys came from Iron Town. So Ashikaka helped them and brought them to the forest. And in the forest there's this kind of lake, but when you're diving into it, your scars and wounds would totally gone and totally healed. So these two guys are healed, and when they're sober, Ashikaka was asking them like, where did you guys come from? And why did you guys hurt? Should I take you back to home or stuff? And yeah, finally Ashikaka took them to Iron Town, and in Iron Town, he met Lady Eboshi. Lady Eboshi is the leader. Lady Eboshi is the leader of the Iron Town. And Ashikaka finds out that Lady Eboshi built the town by clear cutting the forest to claim iron sand and produce iron. And this thing is leading to a conflict with the forest gods. So Lady Eboshi is yeah, trying to kill the spirit forest, and it is totally making Sun mad because she lived in the forest, and yeah, she's of course trying to protect the forest and its spirit. So Sun and Lady Ebushi was in a totally different side. They're fighting against each other's will. And here is our Ashitaka stuck in this kind of situation. He was not taking anyone's side, and he believed that they needed to solve their problem without hurting or killing each other. So, one time, Lady Ebushi was prepared and sat with her emperor to kill the forest spirit. And she's intended to bring the head of this spirit because, according to legend, spirits had good grand immortality. And the battle started and they got the spirit head. They got the spirit head. It's pretty cool. I mean, it's a spirit head. And after that, the spirit was bled and its blood is all over the place, all over the land, and it kills anything it touches. So the forest died. Yeah, everything just died. And Sun, also Ashitaka, was pursued. Jikobo, the one who stole Spirit's head, to return Spirit's head to him, because if they're not doing it, it could be a disaster. Yeah. And after that, finally Jikobo was finally returning the head back to the spirit, and sadly the spirit was dead by his own ghost. And its form washed and healed everything it touched. And also, its form healed Ashitaka's curse. Finally. Cool. After that, Lady Ebushi was like, I was bad. I'm going to change myself and I'm going to heal Iron Town, the better version of Iron Town, if I can do both. Yeah, finally everything is. Everyone's got their own happy ending. Ashitaka was stayed in Iron Town and helped Lady Ebushi and their people to rebuild the Iron Town. Okay, so that's it, the plot, and I'm going to give my thoughts about this film. This film is so cool. It's so cool. I really love the characters involvement because, yeah, Ashitaka was a prince out of nowhere. He came to rest just to find the cure for his right arm, but then he stuck in that kind of situation of two women who are fighting against each other, and he finally kind of found a way to solve their problems. Yeah, and I really love Sun, character, and she's so brave, she's so thoughtful, she's so amazing, she's so wise, and she stands for herself and her family and wolves and forest also. Yeah, and she haven't talked to each other as a human, and she finally met Ashitaka, and yeah, they finally talk and having a real conversation as a human. It's so cool. And the last one is Lady Ebushi. I really love her character's development from the human us human who are always seeking for opportunities and always feeling not enough for everything what we got. And the day was she, at the end of the day, she finally realized that she was bad, and she wants to fix it. She wants to change herself to a better person, and she also wants to build the Iron Town, a better version of Iron Town. Yeah, she pretty much learned something about this accident, and I really love her for that. And also, Studio Ghibli's action for taking this kind of gender equality topic for their film is also something that makes me give a 2 thumbs up for this movie. Because from their characters, main character is San and Lady Eboshi. They're two women, two strong women, two wise women, and it's kind of breaking the stigma of women are weak. And I'm happy for that. Studio Ghibli pay attention to that stigma, and they did something to scream it, like, no, women are not weak, and we can do what guys do, and it's so cool. Thumbs up to Studio Ghibli, and that's pretty much it. Oh, and the plot is kind of slow, and it's making me boring at the first time. As the conflict goes, this movie gets all of my attention because this film is so good. Yeah, I think it's pretty much it. So I'm giving it 9 for 10, but because it's so good and you guys need to watch it. I think it's all. Okay, thank you for watching and see you later. Bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.